1707, the Queen's High Fleet, weary from the wars, was northward bound for the Dover Strait and the sight of friendly shores. But the watch on deck knew the waters well and raised a loud alarm, crying by the wind and the wave, "Scilly lies ahead, we must turn or come to harm. For granite is the hardest stone," he cried, "granite is the hardest stone. It'll tear
an arrogant man, he gave the order clear. "Hold that watch in iron strong, that young man is a mutineer. Give him 100 lashes, hang him from the yardarm tree, and if he lives, then cast him to the waves, and his judge shall be the sea. He'll know granite is the hardest stone," he said. "Granite is the hardest stone. It'll tear his flesh and cut him to the bone. Granite is the hardest stone."
High fleet, it kept its course, blindly unaware that in their path lay the mighty western rocks and the Gillstones' deadly snare. And those ships were cast unto that reef, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 1,000 they perished that day, and then 1,000 more. "Granite is the hardest stone," they cried. "Granite is the hardest stone. It's torn our flesh and it's cut us to the bone.
Neither sank nor swam, the one man to survive, until he was cast on the island strand, more dead than he was alive. And the wife of the isle who found him there, she took his gold, she took his ring, and from under her apron a dagger she drew, and these words she began to sing. "Granite is my heart of stone," she sang. "Granite is my heart of stone. I'll tear your flesh and cut you to the bone.
Take this blow for the men who have died. Take this for the day's work you've done. But take this final blow. much on deck. For he was my own dear son. And above the wind and the roaring tide, so only he could hear, as his lifeblood drained into the sands, she whispered in his ear, "Granite is the hardest stone," she said. "Granite is the hardest stone. Till the day of judgment comes, you'll never rise from this place. Oh,